good to shoot me, Frankie, unless you shot that record, too, because I can run that off for a jury any time at all, and croaking me would only mean they'd have you for two murders instead of one. And one trip to that chair is plenty, believe me. Why don't you go up there sometime and see him burn somebody? I'm telling you, you'd never forget. The room is just about the size of this one. The witnesses are right out there on benches, see, and the chair's right about here. And there's a wire coming up with a little rubber cap on the end, and inside is a sponge soaked in salt water, and they strap that on your leg right here, see? That's what causes all the steam.
Steam?
Yeah, kind of blue-like. And then here's a smaller room. That's where the slabs are. They lay you out in there when they bandage your leg.
What for?
Didn't you know about that? The right leg, the one that gets the juice. You see, when they undo the straps and they lift you out, that right leg snaps up with a kink and your heel hits your backside and they take you in there and they tie it out straight while it's still warm, else they'd never get you into a coffin.
Lay off,
will Frankie,
you?
Over here is a little door that leads from the death house, and you've been out there hoping at the last minute somebody will come with a pardon from the governor, but nobody comes. It's those last 8 hours that drive you nuts. It's that waiting and waiting. Then you order a big dinner, and when you eat it, you throw it up because you got no hope to brace you up then. Finally, just before midnight, the warden comes. He's on time. He's never been late yet, Frank. He's come to take you for a ride. Only it's a walk, Frankie. A slow walk. Like this, see? You're coming in from over there, out of the dark, and your little feet are shuffling, and your pants leg is flapping, and you're looking up, your eyes blinking, and you're saying over and over, heaven forgive me, heaven forgive me. Look at Frankie. Out here, they're all standing up, the reporters and the doctors. A couple of witnesses pass out while they're strapping you in the chair, you see? They put straps here and here, and a big one across here, then there's another one over here that's tight. Oh, it's tight. Then they put a wide rubber band across your eyes, another one across your mouth, so you can't even pray anymore. Then they step back and they leave you there all alone for about 10 seconds, but it seems like 10 years to you. Do you know why they do that, Frankie? Because the warden's waiting until all your breath's out. Because if your lungs were full when you made that lunge forward, you might squeal and everybody'd go nuts. Then they give you 2 shots of 2,000 volts each, and your hair starts smoking, and your leg is steaming, and that left hand is strapped down so tight, starts turning, turning, until finally one finger points straight up to where you're not going.